I'm with Kirsten Robertson over here. She is our business manager back at the station. What are you doing?
I'm testing the glass that we're about to rappel down, and it's a little slippery for my liking.
That doesn't make me feel good. Do you feel better?
That's what I'm here for.
We're going to actually show later on some of our training viz that we had to train for this, otherwise we couldn't do it. Maybe we should have not gone to that. This was in Coquitlam. But do you feel better about that training session we had on Saturday?
Yeah, definitely, because we'll get the feel of leaning back and how the rope works and everything. So we'll be fine.
How do you think we're going to be feeling up there? I know I'm going to be
freaking out,
pooing my pants, maybe. how do you think you're going to be freaking out as well? Or are you pretty going to be relaxed about this?
No, I think climbing over the edge part is going to freak me out, but I don't know. Okay. Too late now.
What do you think of your superhero outfit?
Oh, it's hot.
Okay, it is.
It's hot.
We are going to reveal our superhero outfits later, too, you two. It's going to be great.
Sounds good, Greg. Also, I want to see Kirsten's shoes. We'll check in with you in the 7 o'clock hour to take a look at Kirsten's lucky shoes she's got on this morning.
If there's any problems back at the station, just let us know. This is Captain BT along with Captain LT. How's that superhero voice?
I got to work on it.
These are great costumes. Thanks to Perry Panu back at the station and his mom for putting this together for us. Very nice. Now we have to be courageous when we rappel 20 stories. We have to trust, Kirsten and I, trust the equipment. Right, Daniel?
Absolutely. Have faith in that equipment because it is definitely going to keep you attached to the rope for sure.
So you can just lean back.
No.
I've got you.
Okay. So I'm going to lean back now?
Yeah. Just to test that out. See? Nice.
Somebody help me. Captain BT is going down with Captain LT, baby. Let's do this. How's that for a smile? I'm scared out of my wits right now.
Kirsten and Greg actually had to go and attend this training camp over the weekend where they had to practice rappelling just down a wall. And the interesting thing is, I mean, when you're going down the side of the building, that's the hardest part, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you have to let go and sort of and use your go
you
on your
trust.
Own steam down down the rope. But
yeah.
If you want to stop, you actually have to let go altogether if you want to come to a complete stop. So here's Greg and Kirsten from the ground looking up as they finished their rappel down the side of this building. Again, this is at the corner of Burrard and Hastings in downtown Vancouver. The whole process took about, I think we're hearing about five minutes to get from the top all the way down to the bottom. Can you imagine what's going through their minds right now?
Well, at this point, they know they're in the home stretch. So I would have to think that they're going, you know what, we're okay.
This
we're
wasn't
okay.
that bad,
You know,
yeah.
I think probably the first 10 or 20 steps down, you're going, okay, no, okay.
They both dress up in costumes. So Greg is Captain BT, Kirsten is Captain LT, and this is just the last bit here, the home stretch.
And a lot of people do the costumes and everything. So this is something we'll see likely all day with a lot
yeah.
of companies, right?
All right, let's listen in and see how it went.
Talk to me, Kirsten.
It wasn't as bad as I thought. It was the edge part. Going over the edge was the freakiest part for sure. I would do it again. I totally would do it again.
And it goes a little something like this.
Shangri-La, welcome back. You're watching Lunch Television. There was no jumping this morning when Kirsten and Greg here went and rappelled off the side of a building, not quite as tall as the Shangri-La in downtown Vancouver.
Tall enough.
Yes. How tall was this building, guys?
20 stories.
20 stories. She is correct.
20 stories. Now, this was all for a good cause. Tell us how, Greg, how did you guys get involved in this and what was this all for?
Well, it was for Easter Seals, and this event's been very successful. It's called the Easter Seals Drop Zone. Been going since 2005. They've raised almost three-quarters of $1 million, and this just in B.C. So we raised some money, and this is for kids in B.C. with disabilities.
Yes.
How much money did we
raise? Last time I checked, just over $2,300.
Wow.
There we go.
From
yes.
people in our building,
sure. yes.
mainly, right?
Yep.
Good job. Okay, so we'll show the video here because you guys, this was quite the process this morning. You had to do some training, but Greg, this is you. This must have been the hardest part. What was it like making that step over top of the ledge?
Well, Kyle, right there. Oh, and there we look at Captain LT. Hey, Rob.
There's Kirsten.
I was waiting for actually
Greg at that point to catch up to me. You know what? At that point, once I'd stepped over the ledge, got over that initial fear, and actually started to go, I was feeling pretty good about things.
Kirsten,
honestly.
How did you feel?
The ledge was the freakiest part for me, for sure.
No kidding. Going over the edge. When you guys arrived there and you saw the height of the building, were you like, what did we get ourselves into here exactly?
Yeah. And I made the mistake of looking over the ledge when I first got there because I was curious, and I made Greg stay away from it.
Is it surprisingly peaceful, though, when you're sort of drifting over top of the city like this and just kind of easing your way down? The whole process takes about 5 minutes. What are you thinking during this thing? Are you taking in the view, or are you...
I did look a couple times through the corner of my eyes very quickly and was like, yeah, I'm still really high, so I stopped doing that. I wouldn't describe it as peaceful. It was definitely an adrenaline rush, that's for sure. I should mention this now. Remember that doctor that we interviewed on Breakfast Television? She was a psychologist and anxiety specialist. Well, in talking to her, and we didn't talk about this on the air, but she actually attempted to rappel once and was too scared and had to call it off.
She really? Could be
so,
do it. Wow.
Yeah, so that made me made my palms sweat a little bit more.
Did she make you feel better, though, in talking to her before?
Yeah, we sat down, and she really told me to focus on my breathing. And there we go. Look at this. We're about to touch the ground. This felt so great. Our cameraman, Richard Paris, was there. Kirsten, yeah.
He won.
Captain LT beat me.
Kirsten, how does it feel when your feet actually touch the ground?
Oh, like a relief. Like, yeah. Yeah. It was... Yeah.
The two of you, though, you kind of signed up together for this thing. Greg, you have a huge fear of heights.
I do.
Do you feel as though you've conquered it, though, by doing this?
You know what? A little bit. But for me, I say a little because I don't think I'm still at the point where I could look over something and go, yeah, yeah, that's cool. No, I mean, I don't think I could have done it if I looked down.
How did you guys sleep last night, by the way? I was going to ask you.
I slept like 4 hours, maybe.
I haven't slept well the last couple nights, but you know what? I think I'm going to sleep in this tonight.
Yeah, let's talk about your uniforms really quickly here. You're Captain BT, you're Captain mm-hmm. LT. Show off your unis here. You have a special... Someone helped you make these, didn't they?
Perry Panu in promotions. It was him. He talked about the design with this, and it was his mom that actually put this together. So, yes.
Very cool.
Thank you, Mrs. Panu and Perry Panu.
The cape didn't rip, of course. That wouldn't have been very good.
Right? Oh, we weren't allowed to wear it. It was a safety concern.
Wow.
There's a chance it could get caught and then strangle us or cover our faces. We're blinded. Then we really start to panic.
And, Mike, let's just get a quick shot here of Kirsten's shoes. I want to show off Kirsten's little sneakers that she decided to wear. You were sponsored by Cookie Monster.
Yes, I was.
Every step of the way. Well, congratulations, you guys.
Thank you.
Great
Thank
job.
You.
A really good cause. We're really proud of you guys, too. We'll take a break. Thor is up next here on Lunch Television. He's got the latest DVDs that you can rent this afternoon. Don't go away.
Repowering.